Okay, we're getting there. In this one, we're going to calculate the minimum distance from nearest figure to each ground location using the distance operation in Idrisi. And I think the key concepts here is the distinction between figure and ground and the idea that we're calculating Euclidean distance, which is basically distance on a Cartesian plane. This is my favorite operation by far, and I probably don't even not going to go a whole into a whole lot of defense of that. I think you'll agree with me if we slowly type in distance. And one of the things I like about it is it's such a simple GUI, right? All we want to do is we have our freshman dorm and we want to calculate how far each location is from this freshman dorm, right? So we have an input and we have an output. And this is going to be 6, and it's the minimum distance from the dorm. And if we just say okay, it runs through 4 passes and then boom. I mean, how can you not like that? It's like cue up the Grateful Dead, you have this great fun little image. And so everything here is just representing the distance from Battelle. Now this is all we need to move on, and we're only like a minute and a half in here, but let me just take the opportunity to play around a little bit with this distance so you get a feel for what's going on. The figure ground concept is the idea that we just have a figure that's distinguished from the ground, but the identity of the figure doesn't really matter. And I want to kind of show you that by, let's look at the campus parking. And so again, this is just, we're just playing here. Jeff's idea of playing. We're just nerding out with distance, but it's the best operation to nerd out to. So this is going to be, let me just call this 999, like playing distance. And this is going to be with a Boolean kind of archipelago. Just off the top, you can tell it's probably getting late. And so the idea, if I say OK here, we're going to get another really cool output. And what I have is the minimum distance to the closest parking lot, which again, we don't need for the problem, but just I wanted to show you this, and then I want to actually do this one more time, but rather than using the campus parking Boolean, let's use the parking lot objects. And let's do this as 9999 playing distance objects, be a little bit object or islands concept. So if I say save and say OK, it'll think through it, and we'll get another very pretty much identical raster. And so the reason why I'm showing you this is that whether you use this as the input or this as the input, the distance kind of works the same. It really can't represent the nearest distance to this particular dorm or this particular dorm. It's just representing the distance to, I'm sorry, parking lot. It's just representing the distance to the nearest parking lot. So the distance tool kind of always sees the world more or less just as kind of that there's figures on a ground, and it's trying to figure out how far away each ground location is from the nearest kind of figure. It doesn't care if this is figure 4 or this is figure 5. It's just whatever the nearest thing is that's not part of the background. Does that make sense? Though it's this kind of, it's another way of conceptualizing space where you're just talking about figure versus ground rather than talking about the kind of the object with an identity versus a ground. And so you might think of this as like the silhouettes of people on the beach and this being the ability to see their individual faces. And the distance doesn't, the distance operation doesn't care. And again, we could kind of check this by saying let's insert this. And this is how I got that. This is how I check equivalence, right? You just subtract one from the other, and this is called the difference raster. And if they come out to be zeros, you know that they're actually equivalent, right? So this is all zeros. That means that every value here is the same as every value here. And so anyway, that I think is the main kind of concepts that are across. The other one is just that Euclidean distance, which is means that we're working with distance on a Cartesian plane, which is why we're using, a squared plus b squared is equal to c squared, right? Okay, I'm sorry, it's getting late, and I think that's enough for distance, but there it is.